in spite of all the distractions and difficulties, let's try anyway. Even though we're limping along, even though it's maybe not so brisk, let's try to stumble along here. So this is the mood here. We're going to stumble along. Now, let's say that we wanted to be a new identity. We said, how are we going to do that? We're going to win. We're going to win it. We're going to win a new identity. We're used to winning, but we don't consider what does winning mean. Winning means that something is losing too. Winner and loser. If there's no loser, then there's no winner. So in order for there to be a winner, there has to be a loser. So when we're winning a new identity, what are we losing? We're losing the old identity. There's a loss of identity in order to win a new identity. What if our identity is everywhere? Okay, how do we lose everywhere to win a new identity that is not everywhere? Or is something different than everywhere? Well, in order to win, first we have to say we have to be able to lose. If we can't lose, how can we win? If we cannot lose, how can we win? So how do we lose our identity in order to say we can win an identity? If we can't lose the identity that we are, how can we talk about winning a different identity? It's ridiculous. So the first step is to say that losing our identity is possible. Therefore, winning a new identity is possible. So how do we lose our identity, so to speak? How can we imagine that it's possible to lose everywhereness? What do we do? Well, we imagined what? Space. We imagine space. We think we're seeing space. We believe we're seeing space. Perception, sensory perception, we think we're seeing space. The seeing of space is the way we symbolize the possibility of the loss of identity. Otherwise, we couldn't even play this game of winning a new identity. Now, space actually isn't there at all. We just think we're seeing space. Now, this may seem very abstract, but it's actually extremely factual. But we are sort of stumbling along and trying here. Our perception, sensory perception, seeing of space, is how we symbolize the loss of identity. It's how we symbolize the lost identity, so we can then believe it's possible to win a new identity. If we didn't first symbolize the loss of identity, there's no way we could play this game of winning a new one, because we would know that there's only one identity, which is everywhere. No possibility of winning a new identity. So we symbolize the loss of identity as time-space, space-time. It's space-time, is what we're saying. And then in that space, time, and with form, it appears as though there's all sorts of losing taking place. But if we recognized everywhereness, we realize that nothing is being lost to everywhereness. Everywhereness is not being lost. There's no loss of everywhereness. The rising and subsiding of forms doesn't cause everywhereness to be lost. There's no losing. There's no losing of everywhereness. So fundamentally, we are imagining there's such a thing as space, and then loss in the space, time-space, is a... It's not even a hallucination, it's a desire. We desire to believe that it's there. It's not there at all. It's actually not there at all. There's no such thing as space. And so, what we talk about as enlightenment or realization is not a winning in space and time-space. It's a realization there never was any time-space. So there's nothing to win. Because there's nothing to lose. There is no loss. So when we have these moments of recognizing, oh, there's no time-space, then we say, well, how do I win? How do I win? Oh my gosh, I'm going to lose. Now remember, winning and losing are part of a duality. That's the fundamental duality, winning and losing. If there's no losing, how can there be winning? If there's no winning, how can there be losing? So winning and losing go together. So we can say there's no win-loss, no loss-win. Now again, it seems to be we're reaching, we're stumbling, but that's what we have to do in the face of seeming distractions and difficulties. We simply say we're going to try anyway. That's the way. I'm going to try anyway here to look at this, even though the likelihood of success seems very low. But what we're talking about is not so much success, is dropping the duality of success and failure. So the difficulty that people have is thinking, how are we going to win? How are we going to win? How are we going to win enlightenment? How are we going to win realization? We don't win enlightenment. We don't win realization because there's no way to lose it. If there's no way to lose realization, there's no way to lose enlightenment. That's the root of it, is to realize that there isn't any way to lose it. So if there's no way to lose it, why do we need to win it then? The idea of winning it is ridiculous. So we're more interested in seeing that we can't lose it. We cannot lose enlightenment. So there's no way to win enlightenment. Saying that I'm going to become enlightened is delusional, is dualistic. What we're saying is there is no way that I could ever lose what I am. I could never lose I amness. It's impossible. We're only imagining it's possible. We're saying that space is there. Obviously space is there. No, it's not. It's not so obvious that it's there. We're surrounded by space. Well, what is surrounded by space? You say everything is surrounded by space. Well, that appearance, where is that appearance? Is it surrounded by space? See, perception gives us this mirage of time-space, actually. Time and space is a mirage. And so we can say this. We may not fully accept it right at the moment, but the very act of looking at it this way is actually very profound. That we see we can't win because we can't lose. We're trying to win something in space. We're trying to get that which is totally surrounded by space and is not actually oneness of everywhereness. We are trying to win the space-time-space game. Of course, if we see there is no time and space, how can we win the time-space game? The winning the time-space games is, it would be to say that there's some central point around which everything revolves. That there's some place where it is surrounded by time-space, but that is not time, it is not part of it, it's separate. And we think of that as I. We're trying to find I. Now the problem with explanations or any approach to truth, one moment. The problem is that we're trying to win. We're still trying to win. Which is why I say the entire situation has to be approached by the mood of repentance. The mood of repentance is that is a feeling we're not trying to win. We're not trying to win. This is what opens up the path for us. As long as we're trying to win, it will be sterile. The path will be sterile for us. It won't work. And what happens with me, and I'm sure it happens with everybody, is when you go through an intense consideration in the mood of repentance, and then you come out of that, and you go back to the normal worldly functioning, there's this problem that arises, and you feel like, wow, I'm wasting my time, I can't remember what I did, because we're back in winning mode. We're back in winning mode. The mood of repentance, you come out of this winning mode. Because remember, winning mode presupposes a losing mode. What we're doing here is looking at this presupposition, this presumption, that there is a losing mode. We're saying there is no losing mode. This is very different than the world. The world presupposes there's a losing mode. This is its presumption. This is its premise. Therefore, it's all about winning. And people feel energized. Say, "Yeah, I feel driven to win." That's a presumption. There's a way to lose. There's a losing mode. What we're doing is saying, "No, wait a minute. Maybe there isn't any losing mode. So we don't need to be driven to win. We can remain as we are." But the problem is when we go into this and get close to true enlightenment. It's realizing there isn't any need for enlightenment. There isn't any need to win anything. And we don't quite get it. We realize, wow, I need to stay in this mode. And then you say, well, how am I going to win? Where's the winning? There isn't any winning. and so we say, okay, well, wait a minute. I just want to do a little more winning. And then you presuppose losing. And you're, you know, deluded again, severely deluded. It's taken me all morning. Woke up at 4 a.m. and since then I've been trying to get back to this. And it, you know, what is it, 11 o'clock? 7 hours of, it's taken me to get back to this focus again. I say, yeah, it's really tough. Because I'm realizing, wow, I need to remain in this mode. And I say, well, how can I win? Where's the winning? I want to have a little winning. Then it's gone, gone, gone. Even the little bit of winning, tiny, tiny bit, presupposes losing, which means presupposing losing everywhereness, which means presupposing time and space, all time and space, unlimited time and space. Even the tiniest desire to win presupposes losing our identity. It's possible to lose our identity. And even a little, even to say, well, just a little loss, we couldn't see everywhereness at all. We'd have to see space and believe in time-space. We'd have to cover the totality of everyoneness with the belief in time space, even for an infinitesimal desire to win. And this is where we get tripped up. This is what's happened to me. The ego says, oh, come on, don't you want to win just a little bit? I'll help you win just a little bit. The ego in its, you know, guise says, oh, come on, just a little winning. Here, just a tiny, tiny bit. But that tiny bit of winning has to presuppose loss. It's possible to lose identity. And since our identity is one, you can't lose a tiny bit of our identity. You either see it or you don't. And if you don't see it, what are you seeing? Time, space. And then you're totally deluded. You don't see your identity anywhere. This is the problem. This is the frustration of the path. And this is what we know. We know if we don't stay with this, we're going to go back into delusion. It's horrible. And we think, well, how can I stay with this? How can I win this state? You can't win the state. It's not winnable because it's not losable. Truth is not losable. So we can't win some other state. There's nothing to win because there's nothing to lose. It's not losable. Truth is not losable. Every awareness is not losable. We can't lose it. But we can seem to be lost in time and space. Forms seem to be lost in time and space. But time and space is just an illusion. Now, these are just words, but when you glimpse it, you see it right away. You say, oh my gosh, it was never there. Which means winning has never been there. Which means losing has never been there. it's tough to keep on trying, knowing that even an infinitesimal desire to win will blind you. Will blind you. So I'm saying, well, I'm going to be blinded again. You know, it's like, wow. But this realization that I'm going to be blinded again is frightening, very frustrating. But this is the mood of repentance, is to do not react to this frustration, just notice it, calmly notice it. Remain the calm observer is another way to put it. But a calm observer is not necessarily mean there's no content arising. There is this seeing that of this dynamic arising. We're seeing it and we're feeling the frustration, etc. But I'm maintaining the quote unquote location of calmly observing this. Now some say, well, in order to be calm, I can't look at this. Now that's backwards. What we say is we're going to look at this and make the effort to remain calm. As we look at this, realization is, as soon as we want to win, we're going to lose. We're going to lose the realization that we don't need to win. There's nothing to win, but that we can't lose. As soon as we desire to win, we're going to lose the realization that we can't lose. Just like that. So you could say it's easy to be blinded. We're blinded just like that. Except that there's nothing actually blinding us. We're projecting the belief in time and space. It's not there. It's never been there. It's the how space is symbolizing itself, its form. So seeing, quote unquote, through form, seeing through this, doesn't mean have x-ray vision. It means that we do not see form, well, as symbolizing space. We're not taken in by the delusion of form space. Again, just bear with yourself in the mood of repentance. Just observe. It's just a simple shift. I've made it a few times. It's a completely simple shift, actually. And you just say, ah, so that's it. Oh, okay, it's obvious. Oh, okay. Oh, it's that subtle. Oh, it's just like that. So subtle. But because we want to win, we miss the subtlety. The subtlety is we can't lose. We think each form seems to say that space is losing something. It's a package deal. Form and space go together. We're shifting the terminology a little bit here. Form space. And then the forms can change. And so it seems to be space is losing its form, its formatting, it's changing. Loss of formatting, form space. So we're just looking at here, we cannot lose. Okay, that's way more important than trying to say, well, how do we win? That's not the way. The way is neti, 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 we cannot lose. We cannot lose. No, there is no way to lose. This is what needs to be seen. Form space. Again, this is all completely irrelevant to the idea of winning. So the ego just says, well, waste of time here. How do we win? The ego's saying, how do we win? This is the delusion we're looking at. The Holy Spirit says, recognize that we can't lose. No possibility to lose. This so-called dance of form space is not a loss of spaciousness, which is every awareness. And so, when this clicks in, that's it. We have arrived. We are liberated. We are free. The goal has been reached. When this just clicks in, that's it. There's nothing more than that. There's no way to lose. Seeing that there is no way to lose, that is liberation. Nothing else is liberation. That is liberation. That is freedom. See, we assume the opposite. We think that happiness comes from winning. Happiness comes from seeing there's no way to lose. See, this is very different than winning. Winning always thinks that there's still some losing, but seeing there's no way to lose, that's like steady, pure happiness. So it's happiness that we're not used to, and there's the continuity problem for us. It's an astonishing happiness. It's happiness because there's no way to lose. There isn't any way to lose. So the one that is quote unquote enlightened is an astonishment. Is an astonishment. And of course we say, well, how did they win? What's the big win here? There's no big win. there is realization, there's no way to lose. So we mystify it, you see. We mystify ourselves by mystifying it, what the situation is. And we think, what do you mean there's no way to lose? That's crazy, of course. Well, that's the spirit of wanting to win. It's a desire to win that says, oh, there has to be a way to lose. It's a priori. There has to be a way to lose. See, we don't put it to the test. We don't scrutinize this. We say, well, there has to be a way to lose because I want to win. I want to be seen as a winner. I won prime creatorship because there was a way to lose. If there's no way to lose, how can I claim some victory, some triumph? If there's no way to be defeated, where's the triumph? So we say, well, there must be. And we don't look to see if there is. We just insist there has to be. It's an insistence. It's not a knowing at all. And since we just insist there must be, and then start playing with thoughts, winning and losing, winning and losing, winning and losing with our thoughts, thinking that there must be a way to win. Therefore, there has to be. I have to symbolize winning and losing in my mind and thinking, and then act as if this all this winning and losing is taking place, without ever seeing, looking to see, is it actually possible? We say, well, it has to be possible because that's what we desire. So, see, we see reality always gives us what we want. So you say, well, of course it'll give us a way to lose. But keep in mind, what we're insisting upon is we're going to replace God as prime creator. So we say, well, there has to be a way then for God to lose being prime creator. But there isn't any such way. God cannot stop being. What God is, isness can't stop being isness. It's not possible. So our overconfidence, we're just saying, well, there has to be, because that's what we want. In this one case, we then need to look at this and say, well, no, there isn't any way to lose. We can't lose our freedom. But we don't even look. The problem is, in our desire and confidence, we say, why even look? That's ridiculous. I know it has to be there. And they say, anyone who's looking, it's stupid. Reality manifests everything I want. So it must be there. This is the problem. So we don't look. We don't look to see if it's actually there. It's totally arbitrary. To say that there's form space is completely arbitrary. It's a decision to see it that way. It's not there. It's actually not there at all. Which means we can't win. It's kind of like saying, I've got to win my freedom. No, freedom is a given. You can't win what is a given. Life is a given. We can't win life. Reality is a given. Freedom is a given. We can't win it. Because to win it means we could lose it. We can't lose it. We can't lose what we are. So we can't win what we are. This is the problem. To win it would mean to get it for ourselves, really. You see, so we want to create ourselves, be the creator of ourselves. There's no way to do that. So let us say this desire is winding down, and we say, wow, I have a huge continuity problem. I'm so confused, because it does wind down. This desire, what does wind down? That's what we're doing. This desire is winding down, and so we're looking to say, okay, well, what caused all of this? You know, how did I do all this? Arbitrary. We simply insisted that form space is there, when in fact it's not. So it's not there right now. It's never been there. So this is not a breakthrough. There's no breakthrough needed, no winning needed. It's just that we need to drop the belief in losing. That pure spaciousness, zero dimensionality, everywhereness, can somehow be turned into form space. It cannot. All we're doing is an image. We're just playing with images. So we shift from images to seeing. Vision, from images to vision. So all these images we're seeing are just arbitrary. It's arbitrary, a mirage, and that's not there. Form space doesn't exist. It's just a trick of perception. It's we want to see it, we desire to see it, so we're seeing it. It's like a hallucination. It's not really there. It's not there. Now, of course, one who's hallucinating will say, well, I can see it. Of course it's there. Well, we have to insist it is not there. It is absolutely not there. Form space does not exist. So how does one feel in saying this? If we can remain calm and just say, okay. Not too alarmed, not too argumentative or alarmed. This is the mood of repentance. Don't be argumentative. Even if you feel alarmed, don't be argumentative. Just allow yourself to calm down. This is how we get out of hallucination. We have been hallucinating. There's no question about it. We've been seeing something that isn't there. Form space. So what do we see? What's the vision? space is there. Space, not form space. Space. Zero times zero. That's space. Form space is like 10 times zero, 20 times zero. Space is zero times zero. So what we're doing is we're going from a mirage of form space to a mirage of space. And then the final step, which the Prime Creator takes, is just pure spaciousness. Just pure spacious, just isness. But we are taking the intermediate step, which is the right way. We're seeing space now instead of form space. And in space, the concept of losing, it isn't there. So we say, well, the concept isn't there. So we're still saying, well, the concept isn't there. So we're still referencing concepts, you see, and not being there or not there. We just say, wow, it's not there. It's not there. Form space is not there. Form space is not here, form space is not here, form space is not here, form space. We reference this, oh, it's not here, form space is not here. So losing is not here, there's no losing, no concept of losing here. Form space is not here. Now, of course, the part of us that's been hallucinating has no idea what we're talking about. That's a given. So, as you do this contemplation, consideration, practice, be aware that there is part of us that's saying, you're crazy, you're cuckoo. What are you talking about? I have no idea what you're talking about. That's the desire to hallucinate. That's that part that's insists that what has been hallucinating is there. So of course we understand. We're not trying to change the mind, of that hallucination seems to be there. We're just saying that it's not there. And we're replacing it with space spaciousness. will hallucinate space spaciousness. So let's not take away hallucinating. See, we've got to realize that we are so been hallucinating for so long, insisting that form space is there. We cannot just drop hallucinating, drop form space, drop hallucinating, poof, like that. Now we can take drugs, we can try to force issues. It comes back. And then worse than ever. And then you're really confused. So the loving path is the Holy Spirit, the gentle loving path is say, okay, let's not drop form space and let's not drop hallucinating. Okay, because that's what we've invested our creativity in that. So to honor our investment of creativity in hallucinating. We'll say, okay, we'll keep hallucinating, and we'll keep form space. But what we're going to do is we're going to the form of form space is space. The hallucination is now space, just like zero times zero. Now the ego doesn't like this. The ego says, uh-oh. That's curtains for the ego. So it says, oh, come on, you can do better than that. Don't you want to be enlightened? Don't you want to be, don't you want to be a great teacher? Great teacher, drop it all, come on. No, we don't want to be a great teacher, ego. Let the great teachers be the great teachers. We don't want to be a great teacher, not now. We want to be smart. And isn't that the great teacher? Isn't the great teacher the one that's smart? And so by saying no, we're going to continue to hallucinate. We're going to continue with space, form space. But we're going to hallucinate space. Zero times zero. And ego says, well, you're an idiot. And why don't you just go for everything? Because of continuity problem, ego. But go for everything. End up all confused, and you've seen some that seem to be enlightened for a while, then poof, they lose it, you know. Because why? They wanted their desire and ambition to win was still there. And they tried to say, I want to win being a great guru. That's still winning. I don't want to win being a great guru. I don't want to win. I want to see that I can't lose. And the way to do that is to hallucinate space. Not form space, space. Well, the form of form space is now space. It doesn't seem like we're winning when we say this, because the ego said, well, I thought you wanted to win. No, I don't want to win. I want to realize that I can't lose. So the ego will always dangle this carrot and say, wow, I mean, maybe you'll be like blissful and happy, but you could be a great teacher, you know, a great savior if you just drop hallucinating and form space altogether. You know, why don't you just do that? You'd be greater. That's still ego saying, you could win. That's still the ego. That's trying to revive the desire to win. He said, you can be better than that. You can be better. How can I be better than I can't lose? What's better than that? Nothing's better than that. How do I get to I can't lose? Through the intermediate. How do you get to the big leagues? Through the minor leagues. So that's the way. How do I honor my great... See, the ego is what it's doing, is really tricking us. Saying, you need to be the great guru. What it's saying is, don't honor your creativity. Dishonor your creativity. Drop it all right now. That's not the way. because you'll have a continuity rebound from that. So recognize that our hallucinating of form space is how we have been expressing our creativity for so long. So to honor our creativity, let's say, okay, let's honor our creativity. I don't want to feel like I've dishonored my creativity and I'm without it. I'm in some trance state, enlightened trance state. No, that's not the way. Honor our creativity and say, okay, I'm going to continue to hallucinate. I'm going to continue to use form space, but I'm going to now hallucinate space. And then from that hallucination of space, it's easy then to accept pure spaciousness, isness, pure spaciousness. So if people want to go see a great big, great guru, you know, don't come here. If people, that's their objective. Because our objective here is not to win, but to see that we can't lose. And is to take our objective here is to take the intermediate step, is to honor our creativity by taking the intermediate step. This is the safe, smooth, certain way. We don't want a rebound. We don't want some backlash. We want steady. Spaciousness. Hallucinate spaciousness. Simple as that. And the ego will say, but you're not free of hallucination. You're not enlightened. And I say, it's okay. This is more important than enlightenment. I'm honoring my creativity. Enlightenment can wait. I'm honoring my creativity in the right way, the smart way, which is hallucinate space. Says, you'll never be a winner. I say, I don't need to be. I can't be a loser, so how can I be a winner? See? So we're coming around to where we need to get to. Coming around. End of May, 31st of May, we've come around to it. Come around to it just in time. Quite difficult, actually. I've had a tough time I've made several videos and didn't post them. I was trying to do fancy stuff, green screen, you know, all this stuff. And I said, no, that takes too much time. Forget it. I'm still trying to win. We're seeing that we can't lose. That's our path. Seeing that we can't lose is the right path. It's not how to win, it's how to see that we can't lose. And then that leads simply to business. So we don't resolve the situation by winning. We resolve it by seeing it's impossible to lose. We cannot lose. And honoring our creativity by hallucinating spaciousness. Spaciousness. So all forms remain, but now we're seeing them, that's a space spaciousness form. Forms have a different feeling to us, a different meaning to us. And no form impinges upon this feeling. This is what we're after. This is what we're after. It's there. It's for sure it's there. I wouldn't be continuing this if I didn't know it's there. I know it's there. It's just giving up this, you know, letdown from the ego saying, oh my God, you're never going to be a winner. You're not going to be a big winner. Wow, you're not going to be a big teacher, a big guru, a big savior. You're not going to, you know, all this, the ego's like, you know, trying to make it deflate you, saying, what a loser. I say, how can I be a loser? It's impossible to lose. I'm seeing a space spaciousness. What's being lost? Nothing's being lost. I'm not seeing any loss. Because form spaciousness is hallucination. It's not there. And space spaciousness is just a way of admitting to ourselves, hey, form spaciousness was a hallucination. It was never there. It was never there. But by honoring the creativity of our effort, by keeping space spaciousness, see, that's how we need to do it. Because truly, we have been so incredibly creative. Marvelously creative and just unbelievably, wonderfully creative in our efforts to make form spaciousness real, make loss real. Look at all the efforts we've done. So, of course, you have this deep attachment to this, and we should. We should. We're not trying to get rid of attachment to our creativity. So we can say, now, what a beautiful form of space spaciousness. Oh, lovely form of space. Look at all this space spaciousness. That's what we can do. And then we can just be like over the moon, you know, just so enraptured. I'm just thrilled. Look at this, all this beautiful, lovely space spaciousness. The entire universe is full of this incredibly beautiful space spaciousness. So is this advanced teaching? Absolutely it is. Absolutely. It's where we have to get to. It's where we have to get to. End of May. So I said, hey, very important to end of May. And like it was the 28th, I saw this, and then I had this, so saw the absurdity of what we're trying to do, and it was just like so stupid. It's just like, oh my gosh, it's just, and then you realize that there's no way to lose, so I can't win. And the whole like deflation, you know, of the ego has been occurring. Ego deflation, and so the last several days have been quite tough, remain difficult. I'm able to talk about it now better, so it's getting better. So this is the struggle, the end of May, is we either get this by the end of May here, when we're all getting it. If one gets it, everyone gets it. Minds are one. So getting this is getting it. And I'm not doing this on my own. The whole mind is involved in this. The Holy Spirit's involved in this. I'm just expressing it here. Just some kind of mark or something, but we're getting it. I said, we have to get it by the end of May. It's very important. Why? Because the dance of form spaciousness is about to, a new act is about to happen here. It's like all the actors are on stage. And, you know, in a play, things are happening. And then, you know, suddenly, how plays are, like somebody comes in from the wings and there's a figure, like, oh, and everyone's startled, like, what's that? And a shout, you know. And the whole tenor of the play, the mood of the play, you know, changes. Just like that. And now all the actors are suddenly relating to this new something that's come on the scene, you know, on the stage. So it can just change like that. Change on a dime. And then what happens is the whole winning, losing thing. oh my God, a new way to lose. And then we say, well, wait a minute, a new way to win. You see, duality grips us like that. What happens is, look at this loss, a new way to lose. And we say, oh God, this is horrible. And the ego will say, wait a minute, look at the opportunity here. There's a new way to win. There must be a new way to win, right? You say, yeah, how do I win this? And then poof, you're stuck in the new cycle of duality, just like that. So, space, hallucinate space, honor our creativity. These concepts, this has now here, it's come out in the world. This is what Jesus was aiming at in his teachings here, is to get this. Honor our creativity, intermediate step. Hallucinate a different dream. All of these fundamental teachings, been able to get it. That's not to say my ego is still deflating. Yeah, of course. It's like, wow. You know, no grandiose guru here. You know, that kind of thing. No winner. No big winner. Well, how can I be a big winner? It's impossible to lose. If it's impossible to lose, what meaning is saying I'm a great big winner? A great triumph. If it's impossible to lose, where's the triumph? No triumph. There's no great triumphant guru. There's no such thing. The ego said, you could have been the greatest triumphant guru of all time. Well, there are no triumphant gurus. So saying I could be the greatest of all time, what does that mean? I'd be the only one, but it's impossible. So there isn't any. So there's never been any great triumphant guru. There's no triumph. It's impossible to lose. A loss is impossible. There's no way to lose. There's no way to lose what we are. So where's the triumph? There's no triumph. There's no victory. There's no victory over something. Form space. We can't lose. There is no loss. Impossible to lose. The ego says, you could have been the first. It says that to everybody. Of course everyone can be the first, because there hasn't been any triumphant guru. So of course the ego whispers in everyone's ear, hey, you can be the first. I'll tell you a secret. Nobody knows this, but you can actually be the very first one, even greater than all those. Of course you could be the first, because there hasn't been one, never will be. So this is a seduction of everyone. Everyone gets seduced this way. You could be the first. There isn't any way to lose. Form space is a hallucination. There's no loss of identity. It's not there. So we can't lose. Loss is impossible. We cannot lose. So how can we triumph in victory and win? Cannot. And the ego says, well, I cannot herald you then as the great victor. I'll just forget all about you. Because you see, the ego says, I'm into winning and you're not a winner. It's like, no, loss isn't possible. So this whole play of loss is a hallucination. Form space is a hallucination. It's not there. So the ego says, well, I won't promote you. No promotion, no nothing. You know, the ego says, you'll be a nobody. Nobody even pay attention. Maybe. But everyone's getting tired of this effort to win. So the desire is eroding, and then inevitably everyone comes back to say, wow, I can't win. I just feel like I can't win here. It's meaningless. What's going on? And then the wisdom then is there. It's in the mind. The more that accept it, that it is in the mind, the easier it is to, you know, to accept it. Say, it is there in the mind, the one mind. This wisdom is there. Honor our creativity. Hallucinate spacious space. Hallucinate space. Instead of form space. It's that simple. Hallucinate space instead of hallucinate form space. The simplicity of that, it just hit me. It's like, whoa. So I sort of rocked, like, wow. Hallucinate space instead of hallucinating form space. That's the sum total of the whole teaching right there. So strong, very strongly. All right. So we have a form of teaching now which is more potent than the drama of win, losing, of duality, of loss, and therefore opportunity to win. See, all, loss is what generates the opportunity to win. It's like death generates the opportunity for quote-unquote life. As we see it, a form. So it's the loss of form that we think, the loss that we think is happening, which is generating the belief in winning. That's how it is, actually. We have it backwards. So the way it is to see that there is no loss. Loss is impossible. It's just a hallucination. Then that's how to resolve the situation. Hallucinate space instead of hallucinating form space. Instead of hallucinating form space, hallucinate space. Hallucinate space instead of hallucinate form space. That simple. No doubt that this creates a shock, a stunning effect. I'm stunned that we could reduce all teaching to such a clear choice like this. I said we'd stumble along, we'd try, and look what happened. Of course you're going to stumble up to such as this because you realize it's stunning. So there is a form of teaching that we can at least grasp onto momentarily. You say, well, I can't quite choose. Well, but we can at least look at what the choice is. And then that deflects the world away from us. The loss-win duality. Remember, what generates the engine of delusion? Loss does. Loss is taking the L out of loss and replacing with R, reality. Replacing the L with the R. Lies. is with reality, loss with reality. So loss is what generates, we see, opportunity for winning. We see death, we say, oh hey, you know, let's make life, you know, let's defy this death. Opportunity here to win. Opportunity to win. See, there's something that's trying to take something away from us, so if we can prevent that, we're winning. But not, God's not taking anything away from us. Everywareness is not taking anything away from everywhereness. There isn't any loss. There's no opportunity to triumph, to win. Hallucinate space instead of hallucinating form space. Now, there's some who've gotten this, but they've been so intuitive that they're not able to explain it. They're just like, my thing is, I'm able to explain it and put it in context. I'm sort of a balance between intuitive and concrete explanation. I realize that there are those who are just so super intuitive that they get it. And that's it. They just say, just get it, just get it. It doesn't work so well for others who are. Because if you have not really been that into winning in the first place, and you're not really into losing, you can intuit the thing and freedom. But you don't. What you don't get is this honoring of our creativity is all important. See, what I get that because I put so much effort into form space and creativity into form space. So I truly understand this attachment we have to beauty, to form space, to our creativity. So I know how super important it is to honor that, to honor our creativity. It seems that the real intuitive ones are like flippant, you know, to us. We say, you know, they're just like so flippant, like, oh, just, you know, what's the big deal? Just drop it. What's the big deal? It is a big deal because it seems to us we're dropping our creativity, you know, because our creativity is what is hallucinated all this. So thank God for Jesus because, you know, Jesus is a very humble teacher. He accounts for all this and insists upon it. You must honor your creativity. It's all important. So there's no flippancy in Jesus at all. There's none of this intuitive, drop it all, you know. Certainly, they're saying you can do that. He insists, yes, you can do that. Because that's honoring our freedom. But we also do need to honor our creativity. Both. So hallucinate space. That honors both our freedom and our creativity. Now, I don't know, some of those who say they've dropped it, have they really dropped it? Or are they saying, hey, I know I can drop it, so I'm winning? Is it a subtle form of winning? Sometimes I think that this is the case. Now, there have been genuine cases, but I think a lot of cases of those who claim they're enlightened, that they've dropped it all, is a subtle form of winning. Saying, hey, I know I can win this thing. And so they act like winners. I think that's definitely in play. We're not trying to drop it all. We are choosing to hallucinate space. We're not dropping hallucination. We're not dropping form. We're just hallucinating the form of space. So we're not winning. We're not winning anything. We're not winning. Because we're not losing. One moment, please.
Right.
Well, I guess the clock on the wall said it's time to go, but you get it. You get it. We get it. We get it. I will be back. We'll see what happens, okay? Just let the shock of this settle in, that there is a way. There is a way. There is a way to teach here. There is a way to get it. And we have it. We have it. All right. Very great. That's it.